Hello, welcome to the computer science series on uniform resource locator, which is URL, and domain names, which is DNS. Yeah. So first of all, what's URL? URL actually used to represent a resource on the www, which is World Wide Web. That could be a web page, an image, a video clip, sound file, PDF document, etc. Yeah. So each resource is identified with a URL. So let's look at an example of URL. So for example, this is an example of URL. So if you have https://www.hagun.school/collection/ilovecomputerscience.mp3. So HTTPS is the protocol, then www.hagun.school is the website address, and then we have domain host, which is www, then we have domain name, which is Hagun, and then we have domain type, which is school, and then we have the path, which is collection. Those this can be any path, and then we have the file name, which can be any file as well. Yeah. So this is an example of a URL. Next, let's look at domain name service DNS. Yeah. So what is DNS? DNS actually gives domain names for internet hosts, and it's a system for finding IP addresses of a domain name. User then do not have to memorize any IP address. Just think of it, every host in the internet has a certain IP address. There's no way that we can just memorize every single IP address, because it's like they are like 32 bits and they have like so many numbers. So what happens is that we need a DNS to do the translation. So the typical process is like that. First of all, you convert a host name such as www.hagun.school into an IP address that a computer can understand. For example, 18.192.109.149. So for example, we have this table here, which is a domain name and corresponding IP address. For example, www.hagun.school have this particular IP address, which is 18.192.109.149. Then we have www.google.com, which is have this corresponding IP address, which is 142.251.40.100. So this is the domain name and their corresponding IP address. We do not have to memorize the IP address, we just have to know the domain name. Just type in your browser and they will find the IP address for you. Yeah. So let's look at an example of DNS process. So first of all, you have this user on the left here. They are typing, let's say, the website www.hagun.school into their browser. And then what happens is that first of all, you hit the DNS server one, and you will try to find their corresponding IP address from the cache or database of DNS server one. If the IP address is not being found, you try to hit DNS server 2 and try to get from their cache or database of DNS server 2. Let's say we manage to find the corresponding IP address for www.hagun.school, it will send the IP address back to DNS server 1 and will be stored into the cache or database of DNS server 1. And the next thing that is going to happen is that finally DNS server 1 will actually send the IP address back to the computer, and the computer will establish a connection with the website server using the corresponding IP address. Yeah. So this is the end-to-end flow of a typical DNS process. Yeah. So this is the end of the short series on URL and DNS. Definitely, if you are interested to learn more about computer science knowledge, feel free to subscribe to the channel, and I will see you in the next video then. Bye bye.